Dear students, in the last class we learned how to multiply the two matrices here. So if A and B are the two matrices, then product AB exists if and only if the number of columns in A is equal to the number of rows in B. Then only we say that the product of the two matrices exists here. So today we will discuss some properties of this matrix multiplication and some of the examples of matrix multiplication. So begin with the properties of matrix multiplication. First one is the associative law. So for any three matrices A, B and C of any order, we have product AB into C is equal to A times B into C. So this property is known as the associative property. That means first multiply A and B, you'll get one resultant matrix, then multiply with the matrix C. That should be equal to, if you multiply B and C, condition for multiplication is same. If you multiply B and C, you'll get one resultant matrix, that is multiplied by A, or A is multiplied to that one. So these two values are equal. That means first we simplify the terms within the bracket, then the other terms. The distributive law. For three matrices A, B and C, A times B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, or A plus B into C is equal to AC plus BC. The existence of multiplicative identity. For every square matrix A, there exists an identity matrix of same order such that A into I is equal to I into A is equal to the matrix A. So you know that if A is a 2 by 2 matrix, I is also we consider a 2 by 2 matrix, because for every square matrix A, the inverse exists, or multiplicative identity exists only when the matrix is a square matrix. Therefore, if A is a 2 by 2 matrix, the identity matrix is also 2 by 2. If A is a 3 by 3 matrix, the identity matrix also 3 by 3. So in that case, IA is equal to AI is equal to A here. So these are some properties of matrix multiplication. Next, we will discuss this by giving some examples here. Okay. Next, compute these two. First one example. That is, both are 2 by 2 matrix. So this is 2 by 2 and this is 2 by 2. Therefore, the matrix multiplication is defined. Middle two values are same. Number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of row of the second matrix. Therefore, the resultant is again 2 by 2 matrix. So 2 by 2 matrix, you know the entries. So first entry, first row, first column. Therefore, multiply the first row, first column. A into A, A into A, plus B into B. This is the first row, first column entry. Next one is the first row, second column. First row, second column. Starting with the leftmost here, here. Start with the topmost. First row, second column. A into minus B. A into minus B. Plus B into A. B into A. Only two columns here. Next, second row, first column. Minus B into A. Minus B into A plus A into B. then second row, second column, minus b into minus b, minus b into minus b, plus a into a, a into a. First row, first column, this entry. First row, second column, this entry. Second row, first column, this entry. Second row, second column is this entry. So this is a into a is a square, b into b is b square, a into minus b is minus ab, plus b into a, again minus b into a, plus a into b, and this is minus into minus plus b square plus a square, or this is a square plus b square. This entry is 0. Again minus b a plus a b, 0, a square plus b square. So this is the resultant 2 by 2 matrix. One more example. First check the order of the matrix before matrix multiplication. What is the order? This is 1, 2, 3, 3 rows, 2 columns, and here 1, 2, 2 rows, 3 columns. So number of column of the first matrix should be equal to number of rows of the second matrix. So these two are equal, therefore resultant should be 3 by 3 matrix here. Yeah. 3 rows, 2 columns, 2 rows, 3 columns here. So 2 into 1, first row, first column, first entry. 2 into 1 plus 1 into minus 1, 1 into minus 1, first row, first column, that's over. Next entry, leave some space, don't put any commas here in between the entries, leave some space. First row, second column, so 2 into 0 plus 1 into 2. First row, second column. Next, first row, third column, 2 into 1 plus 1 into 1. Okay, next one. First row is over, then start with second row. Second row, first column, 3 into 1 plus 2 into minus 1. 3 into 1 plus 2 into minus 1. Next, second row, second column, so 3 into 0 plus 2 into 2. 3 into 0 plus 2 into 2. Second row, third column, so 3 into 1 plus 2 into 1. 3 into 1 plus 2 into 1. Next, last entry, last row here. Third row, first column, third row, minus 1 into 1 plus 1 into minus 1. Third row, second column, minus 1 into 0 plus 1 into 2. Third row, third column, minus 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1. So the resultant is 3 by 3 mat. So that's equal to 2, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, so 2 minus 1. 2 into 0 is 0 plus 2, 2 plus 1. 3 minus 2, this entry 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, 0 plus 4, 3 plus 2, then this is minus 1, minus 1, 0 plus 2, minus 1 plus 1. Therefore, this is resultant. 2 minus 1 is 1. 0 plus 2 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. 0 plus 4 is 4. 3 plus 2 is 5. Minus 1 is minus 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. So, this is the matrix multiplication of these two matrices. Therefore, you should careful about the order of the matrix. Then only we can write the multiplication. One more. Three minus one, three. Minus one, zero, two. And two minus three, 1 0 3 1. Check the order. What is the order? 2 rows, 3 column. Order of this is 3 rows, 2 column. Therefore, matrix multiplication exists and is of order 2 by 2. Multiply first row, first column. So, 3 into 2 plus minus 1 into 1. Plus 3 into 3. First row, first column. Next, second entry. First row, second column. So, first row, second column. 3 into minus 3. 3 into minus 3. Plus minus 1 into 0. Plus 3 into 1. Then this entry is second row first column. This entry is second row first column. So second row first column minus 1 into 2 minus 1 into 2 plus 0 into 1 plus 2 into 3. Second row second column. So minus 1 into minus 3 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 1. Minus 1 into minus 3 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 1. So the order is 2 by 2. So this is 3 into 2, 6. Minus 1 into plus 1 is minus 1 plus 9. Minus 9, 0 plus 3, minus 2 plus 0 plus 6, and minus 1 into minus 3 is plus 3 plus 0 plus 2. 6 minus 1 plus 9, 14. Minus 9 plus 3 minus 6. Minus 2 plus 6, 4. 3 plus 2 is 5. So this is a 2 by 2 matrix. So in some cases, the product of the two matrices is a zero matrix. But it is not necessary that one of the matrices is a zero matrix. In algebra, if there are two elements, A into B is equal to 0, then we say that either A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. If one of these two is equal to 0, then we say that the product AB is equal to 0. But in a matrix, if there are two matrices A and B, if the product is equal to 0, then it is not necessary that either A is 0 or the matrix B is 0. For that example is, if I consider the matrix A as 0, minus 1, 0, 2 and matrix B as 3, 5, 0, 0. So if you consider the product AB here, if you take the product of these two, that is a 0 matrix. So usually we write this as 0 matrix of order 2 by 2. So here the product AB is equal to 0, but neither A is a 0 matrix nor B is a 0 matrix. So there is a chance here. So we cannot directly say that A is a 0 matrix and B is a 0 matrix. Sometimes it is possible, sometimes this is not possible. Therefore, this is not necessary that one of the matrices is a 0 matrix if the product of the two matrices is a 0 matrix.